Hi children, welcome you for the SOSI class. Previous class we have discussed about the lesson interior of the earth. Based on the movement of the plate is divided into exogenic forces and endogenic forces. Exogenic forces, endogenic forces. So X means external. The changes will happen, surface of the earth is called as exogenic forces. In means in, just to keep your mind, in means inside. So changes will happen, interior of the earth is called as endogenic forces. Okay, surface of the earth, the changes is called as exogenic forces, and interior of the earth, the changes is called as endogenic forces. So based on the endogenic, earthquake, volcanoes is the example for endogenic forces. So previous class we have discussed about earthquake. Today class we are going to see the topic is volcanoes. From the earth crust, okay, the changes will happen in earth crust. This rock, okay, this rock melt and it will come magma, change to magma. This rock is changed to magma. It will come outside the earth, surface of the earth is called as lava. Okay, so this magma, this is called as magma. This melting rock is called as magma. And this magma will come surface of the earth is called as lava. Okay, so inside the earth is called as magma. And surface of same magma will come surface of the earth is called as lava. Then this opening vent. Okay, from which way it is coming? From this open vent. Okay, so this opening open place is called as vent. Okay, so this open place is called as vent. Okay, sometimes if our side also has the open vent, so it is called as side vent. Okay, it is called as side vent. So this is the open vent. This opening place is called as vent. This magma will come outside the earth from this through the veil. So it is called as vent. So this open place is called as vent. Sometimes as a place, the side also, the magma will come surface of the earth. So it is called as side vent. Okay, so it's called as side vent. Then this open vent, the magma ashes will come outside the earth. So this vent change the shape, funnel shape. Okay, this funnel shape change to funnel shape is called as crater. Is called as crater. Okay, this vent means just to open the place is called as vent. But when the magma is coming surface of the earth, in that time something, some ashes, okay, some minerals occupy this vent. So shape is changing to funnel. So this funnel shape is called as crater. Okay, so this funnel shape is called as crater. Then after the change, the crater is changed to huge size. Okay, next time the crater is changed to huge size and changed to basin. Okay, this crater is changed to basin. Basin means down. Okay, so up and down. So this basin, this crater is changed to basin. So it is called as caldera. It's called as caldera. Okay, you understand? So volcanoes, from the earth crust, the molten magma. Okay, the eruption of the magma will come in surface of the earth is called as lava. Then the opening place. Okay, this opening place is called as vent. This opening place is called as vent. And the changes from the vent occupy the ashes, some changes is called as crater. Okay, the shape, increasing the shape is called as crater. After this crater, again occupied more ashes and increasing more shape and huge size. Okay, change to huge size and basin. The shape goes to the basin is called as caldera. Okay, do you understand? Next, we are going to see the topic is causes of volcanic activity. We are located in surface of the earth. Okay, but the depth of the earth, the temperature is increases every 35 meters, 1 degree Celsius. Every 35 meters, 1 degree Celsius. So in that circumstances, the interior of the earth semi-molten, the rock is getting semi-molten, is called as
magma. That magma will come surface of the earth is called as lava. Okay. If you want to learn about the volcano, means the study of the volcano is called as volcanology. And the people study the people. Which people study the volcanoes? They called as volcanologist. Okay. Next, you are going to see the topic is nature of volcanic eruptions. The magma rises slowly to the surface of the earth and it spreads most of the area. Okay. This magma rises quickly to the surface of the earth. Lava is thrown high into the temperature. Because of temperature, lava is reached surface of the earth. So not only lava, ash, steam, gases and pieces of rock also reach to the surface of the earth. Okay. This type of eruption is known as explosive eruption. Explosive means burst. So burst eruption. This terrible explosion on the island of Krakatoa. It was happened in 27 August 1883 in Indonesia. It is example for explosive eruption. And lava flow is affected by viscosity. Okay, the flow of lava is affected by viscosity. So what is viscosity? The example, honey has high viscosity. If you touch the honey means if you feel. The honey has high viscosity, it flows slowly. At same time, water has low viscosity, it flows very speed. Okay. So the viscosity of lava is determined based on amount of silica and water in magma. Okay, the based on the lava viscosity is based on amount of silica and water in magma. The high viscosity means lava is rich in silica. Okay, in the lava is rich in silica and little water. But low viscosity means in the lava the silica is little and water is more. It moves rapidly forming the smooth flow. Low viscosity, the lava is move very fast. Okay, see the picture. This, it is the explosive eruption. In that time, the magma is outside the surface of the earth is called as lava. So based on the movement, based on the movement is viscosity. Okay. Next, we are going to see the topic is types of volcano. The shape of volcano is based on type of lava and force of the eruption. On the basis of shape, there are three types of volcanoes. Shield volcano, cinder cone volcano, composite volcano. Shield volcano. The shield volcano is formed is quite eruption. Okay. Eruption means based of lava with low silica content. This volcano is content low silica. And such a volcano has a wide base. See the picture. Wide base and cone with gentle slopes. See the top of the picture. Cone with gentle slopes. So earth crust is called as magma. This magma will come surface of the earth is called as lava. Okay. So volcano of the Hawaii Island is the example for shield volcano. Next, cinder cone volcano. Cinder cone volcano have the rich silica. Okay, it has the rich silica. But sealed volcano have only the less silica. But cinder cone volcano rich mass silica. The trap gases inside the volcano until enough pressure. So this one have more pressure push the magma out of the earth crust. Okay, so this cinder cone volcano have the rich silica. So have the more pressure to pull the magma out of the earth crust. When this type of volcano erupt, it release surface of the earth's gases, ash, then rock, many material. So this great forces throwing them several kilometer up into the atmosphere. Okay, because I have more silica, so the pressure is heavy pressure, the push several kilometer the atmosphere. Okay, so they are known as cinder cone volcanoes. This is the example for cinder cone volcanoes. Many volcanoes of Mexico and Central America belongs to cinder cone volcano. Next, composite volcano. Composite volcano are made of alternative layers of lava, cinder and ash. Okay, this composite volcano is called as stratovolcano, because what is called strato? Strato means layer. This volcano form many layers, alternative layers of lava, cinder and ash. So only it is called as stratovolcano. Strato means layer. So St. Helens is the example for composite volcanoes. Okay. Do you understand types of volcano? So shield volcano is contained low silica, cinder cone volcano is contained rich silica, and composite volcano is contained alternate layers of lava. Okay. Then volcanoes are also grouped according to the periodic. So it is called periodic. Here the time is called as periodic. Okay. So based on the time, volcanoes is divided into active volcano, dormant volcano, extinct volcano. Active volcano. So active volcano that erupt frequently. Frequently means often will happen is called as active volcano. So mostly this active volcano is located in Pacific Ring of Fire belt along the Pacific coast. There are 600 active volcanoes in the world. Example, Mount Stromboli in Mediterranean Sea, St. Helens in USA, Pinatubo in Philippines. So this is all example for active volcano. The world biggest active volcano is Mauna Loa in Hawaii, 3255 meter. Okay, next one is dormant. So dormant volcano have shown no sign activity for many years, but they may become active at any time. Okay, do you understand? Active volcano often will happen, frequently will happen active volcanoes, but this dormant will not happen many years, but suddenly any one day will happen. So it is called as sleeping volcano. It is also called as sleeping volcano. So for example of sleeping volcanoes are Vesuvius Mountain of Italy, Mount Fujiyama in Japan, Mount Krakato of Indonesia is the example of dormant volcano. Okay, next one is extinct. This type of volcano top extinct. Extinct means erosion. Volcanic mountain have been eroded. This mountain will be eroded. See the picture. So volcano means it will be huge, but it is eroded. Okay, it is eroded. So example of extinct volcanoes are Mount Baba of Myanmar and Mount Kilimanjaro and Mount Kenya of Africa are example of extinct volcano. Do you understand? The active volcanoes are erupt frequently are called as active volcano. It will happen frequently is called as active volcano. Next one is dormant. So this dormant volcanoes have shown no activity for many years, but they may become active at any time. It is called as dormant volcano, or it is also called as sleeping volcano. The extinct volcano, see the picture. This extinct volcano, top of extinct volcanic mountain have been eroded. It is not active. It is called as extinct volcano. Next, distribution of volcanoes in the world. So there are 600 active volcanoes, 1000 of dormant volcanoes and some extinct volcanoes. They occur along the coastal mountain ranges, offshore island and middle of oceans, and few in interior of the continent. So there are three major zones. Zone means region. So there are three major zones of volcanic activity in the world. The circum-Pacific belt, the mid-continental belt and the mid-Atlantic belt. Mid means middle. Okay. Circum belt. So this is the volcanic zone of the convergent oceanic plate boundary. So it is called convergent. Both ocean plate, the joining place, ocean plate, both plate, the joining place is called as convergent. It includes the volcanoes of the eastern and western coastal area of Pacific Ocean. So it will happen in eastern and western coastal area of Pacific Ocean. This zone is popularly termed as Pacific Ring of Fire because 2/3 of the world volcanoes happening this Pacific Ring of Fire. For example, what is called 2/3? For example, 3% of volcanoes it is happening means 2% is happening in this Pacific Ring of Fire. Other 1% is other places. Okay, so it is called as circum belt. Next one is mid continental belt. So this is the volcanic zone, convergent continental plate. So both, what is called convergent? Both continental plate, the joining place is called as convergent. So the zone of convergent continental plate boundaries that include the volcanoes of Alpine mountain chain, the Mediterranean Sea, and fault zone of Eastern Africa. It has happened in this area. So the important volcanoes are Vesuvius, Stromboli, Etna, Kilimanjaro, and Kenya. Then surprisingly, the Himalayas have no active volcanoes at all. Okay, this mid-continental belt, surprisingly, and Himalayas, there is no any active volcano. There is no any active volcanoes. Okay. Next one is mid-Atlantic belt. So this belt represents the divergent boundary of the plate. So convergent means joining place is called as convergent. It is divergent, it is going the opposite side. Okay, so this belt represents the divergent boundary of plate located along the mid-Atlantic ridges. So this is happening in mid-Atlantic belt. Island is the most active volcano area, is located on mid-Atlantic ridges. So St. Helena and Azores Island are the example for mid-Atlantic belt. Okay. Next one is recap. The molten rock material within the earth together with gases is called as magma. The molten rock, okay, the molten rock joined with the gases is called as magma. And if the magma rises quickly to the surface, the lava throws the eye into the temperature. The magma reached to the surface of the earth is called as lava. How it is reaching to the earth means because of high temperature, so it reached to the atmosphere. Okay, it is called as lava. Okay, children. Next, answer the following. So your question is, explain about volcano and its types. So explain about volcano and its types. Next question is, write a detail about distribution of volcanoes in the world. Write a detail about distribution of volcanoes in the world. Next one, current affairs. It is very important in our day-to-day life. So today our current affairs is, who is the speaker of Lok Sabha? Who is the speaker of Lok Sabha? Mr. Om Birla. So what is Lok Sabha? We are electing the Prime Minister of India. Okay, our Member of Parliament, Prime Minister, the places, the Parliament is called as Lok Sabha. So speaker is the mediator of both ruling party and opposition party. But speaker is appointed by only the ruling party. So who is the speaker of Lok Sabha? Mr. Om Birla. Okay, I hope you understood this session very well. This class will be continued in the next video. Thank you. Have a peaceful day.